this is not a constructive video. We're gonna ramble about the shit we
do a video of like things we like. It's really like, oh yeah,
yeah, that's all right, yeah.
Things we hate.
Things we hate. Oh my god.
Yes.
Getting it off our chests. That seems a community of 25 viewers.
Our chests.
Don't. Man, you see that bulge?
Oh man, it's real.
Getting all that bulge.
All up in there.
Don't worry, when you think that's so good.
Yeah.
You know, and you're like totally tame it down.
Well,
because you don't want to offend people.
Look. People characterize themselves by the things that they don't like.
It's kind of weird, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, like, look. Have you ever been playing a game and there's just like some guy that comes to the game sessions every week and you're just like, oh, I hate his style of gaming. Like, literally, I hate him.
You don't really hate him though, eh?
No, I play with some people that I really don't like.
Yeah, that's true.
I once told this dude that he was a fucking idiot, and he didn't understand that I was, like, out of game, telling him he was a fucking idiot. I was like, oh, you hurt my soul. But it seems it's like actions in games where...
That was very funny, though, when you did that.
Yeah.
That was really funny. And then I realized that Jet was saying, you're a fucking idiot to the guy, right? And he's like... But my character says to him, I don't care about that.
And everyone else in the room is just like...
And Jet's like, no, you are a fucking idiot. And the guy still didn't get it. And I just went, okay, let's move right along now, guys. It's like, oh, there's a bar fight.
Yeah, it's just like when you got a person that just...
Doesn't gel.
They think too literally in the sense of like, oh well, this really should work because this and this and this. And it's like, no dude, you're being a fucking neckbeard right now. It really wouldn't work. I just remember this one time where these two guys we were gaming with, there was like a pit and for some reason there was fucking bugbears or something in it. I can't remember the context of the game. I just remember how much I hated that moment because it was like, oh, we'll make a fire and burn these guys. And just like, what are you gonna make a fire out of? There's like twigs and stuff. And they're like, yeah, we can make a fire. And it's just like, okay, you make this small ass little fire. And they're like trying to burn these
bugbears
or whatever they were in a pit with a twig fire. They're like, yeah, no, it's a fire. It'll hurt them. And it's just like, yeah, a lot of it, but not a fucking twig fire.
Yeah, it's and like, if you build like a real one, anyway, if you build a raging one, you'd have no air.
Yeah.
And you'd all die.
Yeah.
God, it's dumb.
So it's just like...
Stupidity.
It's things
problem
like that.
Problem with Jet, though, is that you're pretty intelligent, so, like, when you game, you want people who are intelligent.
Let's not go too far.
No, you're fairly... Let's say moderately intelligent, then, if you don't want to go too far. So-so? So-so? Mediocre?
Yeah.
You get there?
Yeah, well...
Getting there.
I'm alive. I'm still alive.
He's breathing. He wants other people to breathe as well. At least a little bit of breathing.
Yep.
Would be good. Anyway, people like to play with people who are of a similar gaming style to them. I don't think that's a problem, right? And I know Stu's thumbs runs into this, right? So Stu, if you're watching, I feel your pain. Is that you've got a character, a guy who plays, who's really good at role-playing, and likes to do investigative characters, and likes to get into that, right? One of his plays is like that. Whereas the other guys are all like, we want to kill things. And we're like, what? And they're like, oh, we just like to hack and slash, we just want to kill things.
Yeah.
And they're intelligent people, but they just feel like they just want to chill out, play a game, and kill things.
Which is, like,
fine
when everyone's on the same level. Like,
but if there's one guy who wants to do one thing, and the other guy's just always just want to kill things. Fuck, that's so shit. So it becomes really hard, you've got two different clashing styles, you know?
That poor, poor player.
I know, I'm more on his side, like I don't really find it that fun just to roll dice and smash things. In fact, the more we play, the less you roll dice. It's kind of weird.
Well, I mean, like, if Oliver wants to go do that, like, he'll go play Warhammer. I'll go play fucking World of Warcraft if I want.
I wonder
if
like, I play Shogun.
Like, if I want, just mindless like, hack and slash, yeah, I'll just go play a video game.
Video game.
Like, role-playing for me is total just like...
Story, man.
Yeah, you're playing a... Well, I'm not fucking playing me. You know, I'm playing someone else, chucked in a situation, and they have to MacGyver their way out of it.
It's just awesome. The more MacGyvering, the better.
Yeah. MacGyver. Know. Do that shit. I don't know, that's what I hate. It's your turn.
What else do I hate? I hate it when DMs have arbitrary rules and think that they're fucking God. I hate that. So, I mean, it can come in many forms, but I hate it when I, as a player, see now I'm used to being a raider, and, or a GM, rather, and so it's hard for me to relinquish control, utterly. So if I'm playing, I want to describe what's going on. And I want to create stories with the narrator, right? So I think, oh, well, I rolled pretty well. How about this happens? And then the DM's like, no, that doesn't happen. Blah happens. I'm like, why the fuck does blah happen? Like, I'm the one doing the action. I should say how it happens. And they're like, no, I'm the DM. My fucking rule is law.
Yeah.
And so they'll fucking stick on their dig just to fucking say I'm the boss. And by that point, I'm just like, you know what? I'm not playing this game. I'm done here. Fucking done here. I'll go play something else like a computer game. So I find that hard. I don't like it at all. It just throws me out. Some guys, on the other hand, will be whiny players who just want to fucking nitpick the shit out of you when you're a DM. And so you have to be like, no, dude, like, I'm the DM. But the more that I play as a DM, the more chilled out I am. And the guy really wants to argue. I say, yeah, sure, you can have that.
Yeah.
Like, if guys want to have more equipment, I used to be, like, really anal about that. Like, you start with 10 gold pieces and a sword that's just like this and some armor, but not too much good stuff. And now I'm just like, yeah, whatever. I mean, fuck, what do you want? You know, put a few points in that. That's cool. You got a house, you got some stuff. Do you want anything else? I mean, throw it in there. I had one guy who started with, like, a fucking car. Filled to the gills. He had fucking 2 pages of weapons on it. And now he was like, oh, I'm going to take 8 on resources. And then I was like, yeah, okay. And then he was a bit like, oh. And then he realized that it was like supposed to be taking each weapon separately as points. And he was like, oh, no, I would play because... And I was like, actually, it's cool, man. Like, I have no problem with playing with that. You can have 10 million guns if you want them. I mean, you can only fire one at a time. Yep. and the infected really don't care. I don't care. You can have a fucking bazooka if a tank. Like one of my games, players do have a tank, right?
There you go.
It's fine. Okay. So as in...
Because they're gonna lose it anyway.
Oh yeah, that's right. It doesn't matter to me. I mean, like, fucking... They need to eat. They need to sleep. I can play a game with it. I'm not limited.
Yeah.
If they're powerful, I'm not limited. So, you know, Stuart's playing a game. He's riding a dragon. And he's, like, fighting things that are, like, insanely powerful. Well, it's fine. I mean, there's gods. I mean, you can die. It's not a problem.
Yeah.
You know, you're gonna... Well, you can fight dragons? Cool. Well, how about 10 of them? Can you fight 10?
I don't think so.
Yeah,
I mean, like, back when we first started gaming, like, remember those always just like those big ass stacks of books? Like, there'd always be like a separate table.
Yeah.
To have all
like
the books.
8 or 10 books, yeah.
Yeah, and then you'd be like, oh, wait, this thing's got these stats or this rule, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
And now we're just down to like the one book. And it's just like, when does the book even get picked up anymore?
Not at all.
Like,
I mean, I wrote the book, so...
Yeah, like, obviously that you wrote the book, but I mean, like, I've been doing, running a game for him. I haven't touched the book once.
It's because we've got a simple, basic rule set. Well, that's really what it comes down to.
I don't think that's just the way the industry's moving now. I mean, like, when doing, like, the Q&A with Keith, and even the day before when you were in that round table discussion for Aethercon, that really looks like how a lot of the whole community is just going,
less crunch.
A big rules lawyery thing going on, and now a lot of people, I mean, there's probably still heaps of people that are like, yeah, I love my books, and fair call, yeah, look at all the books behind us.
Yeah, we love them.
But, you know, I think it's just so much fun to, like, not hold the game for that one rule.
Now, here's one thing that I hate, speaking of which, right?
Yeah.
Wes, if you're listening.
Yeah, Wes.
Pay heed. Now, when the Wes started gaming with us, he was like, what, 23 and we're like 14, right?
Oh, so my God.
He was like the big man. He was like,
he
was the adult. He had no books. He hadn't bought any, right?
That's true.
I think in the end, he bought a player's handbook, AD&D, right?
Mm.
And we had like 1d10 each and like a couple of dice. And he made it all up out of his head. Because he had no modules, he had nothing, no prep work.
Even when he did get a book, he'd then sell it on like a couple of days later because he'd read through it and was like, all right, cool.
Yeah, so he never had any prep work, he never had anything. And he just sort of like, run. And we never had to wait for anything. Mm. It was like instantaneous and the adventures were amazing.
Yeah.
Like, and D&D, AD&D is just, it's an amazing setting because it was so fucking terrifying.
Yeah, I mean, for all its flaws, I loved it.
It was great fun. So much character.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't like what they call Thaco or what we call Thaco.
Love Thaco.
Oh, I didn't really like it.
Loved
I mean, it was like, it couldn't work out what the hell to roll, but apart from that, it was fine, right? But you know what? It was just like, you were thankful for small things. Like, +1 sword was amazing.
Yeah.
And you felt like, I still remember like every game that we played down to the last detail in AD&D. community. Every game. It was amazing and scary. And so the Wes used to just run, fly by the seat of his pants. He used to, and then he'd get like an adventure and he'd run us through it, but he'd like modify it or whatever. It didn't really seem to give a shit. And it was awesome because they all made sense and all went way through. It was rad.
Yeah.
And then 3.5 came along.
The curse at 3.5.
The Wes moved to the US, adopted version 3 first, and then 3.5.
Came back with a new religion.
And you know what it was like? We just had to spend all this time with the books, the game slowed down, it was like all about the rules.
There was like constant charts.
And checking. Even though the 3.5 and 3.0 aren't that complicated, really.
No. I mean, they're not, but
it was just completely different. It was a big change. Big shift. But the point was, don't lose the story. Don't lose the flow of the game for the sake of what to roll. I really don't give a shit. If it's hard, roll high. If it's difficult, roll lower. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
You can boil it down to that. Just I mean, I do care
work it out
about specifics.
Yeah.
But you can prep it so that it doesn't take 10 minutes to check a chart every few moments, right?
Yeah.
But, you know, I'm just saying, like, we're talking about things we hate. I hate having to check the books. I'm a lazy. I also like the flow of the game. I hate it when, you know, I hate it when a DM invents something and I can see they're inventing it, but I don't like them to go, oh, check the book. What does the book say? Oh, no, you can't do that. Oh, can't find it. Well, what's in there? You know, it's like, oh, fuck, it's just this game.
Yeah.
Hate's a strong word. Maybe I should just call it
fucking hate it. Hate it, man.
Good old Wes. Fuck, I miss that guy. So much quality.
It's just shitty when you're like really digging the mood, really into the mood, and then you gotta stop and it's just like
kill.
You're back into reality.
Kills it.
Suddenly you're not level whatever fucking mage blasting motherfucking kobolds or whatever. And then suddenly it's like, that kobold is behind cover, blah blah blah, blah blah blah, and then like you're arguing a point, he's arguing a point, and then suddenly you're just two fucking dudes in a poorly lit dungeon arguing semantics over a fucking couple of dice. Like, where's the fun in that?
Yeah.
Just keep being that dude. Keep blasting that thing. You guys can work it out. Little bit of common sense.
Common sense.
No, like, leave the books as far away as possible. Just keep rolling with it.
Yeah. Now the problem is that when people become rules lawyery and they just like min-max the shit out of their character, you get this less in immersion because it's so fucking brutal.
Fucking munchkins, man.
But munchkins, when you're coming down to like big HP combats is when the munchkin threat becomes real.
The munchkin.
Really does. Real. You know, you made the character for Tom. Tom, if you're watching this, which you probably won't be.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you're watching this, that friggin' character was bullshit.
I made this, like, winged ethereal elf with, like, bullshit HP
26
archer.
Dexterity. Thank you.
Yeah, bullshit fucking
plus
dexterity.
Plus 6 or something? I don't know what the fuck.
I'd been thinking about this character for a while. I was like, yeah, this would be, like, so... And I made it, and I was just like, this character is so fucking bullshit. Yeah. And I ended up giving it to Tom, because, like, Tom is a new player at that point. And it was just...
couldn't die.
Dangerous.
Like, Tom would fall asleep. He would crash himself on sugar before he gamed.
Yeah.
And then he'd fall asleep in the middle of the game. Then, like, he'd just jump up and be like, oh, what? And just, like, start rolling to hit. And then he'd kill the bad guy in, like, one round.
Yeah.
And that's it. Game over. You know what? It sucked. Yeah. In the end, I got my revenge, though.
You made the mistake of giving him
the adventure
in a game.
Didn't have the heart to destroy it.
He got a fucking bow
so
that had endless arrows.
You know what, though?
Never give that. Never.
I should have just killed his character.
Yeah.
I was a bit soft as a DM at the time, and there was a couple of times when his character probably would have died, really, but I just didn't let him die. You know, it's pretty lame. That's another thing I hate. DMs. You gotta kill them. You gotta kill them.
Don't be soft, man. If they've done something stupid, like, they gotta...
I've made these mistakes. You can't have them just disfigured. Yeah, you gotta kill them. You know, if their arm's severed, their arm is severed. It's brutality. That's what life's all about.
Man, if you are to like, a skate park, or you go do, like, a sport, or you go do anything, and you do something fucking stupid, and you get hurt or something, you're gonna learn from it.
Yeah.
To an extent. Like, I know plenty of you guys have, like, broken limbs. I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna go back to that skate park and do the same thing. But...
didn't learn.
Well, they're learning an aspect, you know, they're not gonna do that exactly the same that time, but you know, they did something stupid, copped something bad, and then you know, in some aspect or form, they learn from that.
Yeah.
If you don't kill your fucking players, man, if you just go like, oh, no, it's okay, you know.
You just get badly hurt.
The magical item keeps you alive. Like, there's danger.
Or, even the Wes did this. The Mighty Wes. He used to be the Almighty Reaper. The most terrifying of all DMs. A killer of characters. The slaughterer of PCs. But he got attached to Randolph Hall. 26th level. Yeah, it's a name out of the Wheel of Time. Anyway, it was friggin', I think, Yuri's character. Guy from the States. Anyway, then he got our characters through something, and he's like, oh, time was frozen.
Oh, yeah.
And then you go through a portal to come in and save his character. I'm like, dude, what the hell are you doing?
Yeah.
Wes.
And we were, like, playing with this guy on, like, voice chat, and Wes, Oliver, and I were in the room, and was like, are you really saving this guy just so you don't kill this character? Fucking lame. Like,
it was lame.
We were like portaled into this room for like no apparent reason just to save this guy and then portaled out without like...
I was tempted to just stand there and watch.
Yeah.
We should have just done that, shouldn't we?
Yeah, I mean like...
We should have just stood there and watched. Will we stand back?
Well, we were like 16 at the time or something. 16, 17, like...
Was that long ago? Bloody hell.
Yeah, yeah.
No, we're like 19.
Oh, yeah, actually no, we would have been 20.
No, I'm like 19.
No, because I was... 18, 19. Yeah, no.
18 or 19.
You're right, yeah. Yeah.
Wow, that was a long time ago.
Oh.
Reminiscence.
I had this great moment.
That was amazing. Okay, this was good.
Okay.
I know what you're talking about.
Okay, so.
I know what you're talking about.
So there was this,
so brilliant.
This gamer, who's actually the same gamer that I told was a fucking idiot to his base. I had to play with him again in one of the Wes's games.
Oh, shit.
And, this pandered to him so bad. Just, like, let him get off with such stupid stuff. Like, hovering discs, and he just kept on casting them, and he just put
Tensor's floating disc
fucking shit on them. He just had like weapons and bullshit, and they'd follow him about everywhere, and we were just like, oh, this fucking sucks. And like, he was kind of lucky he got us through one of these things just because he had so much shit on him, so I'll give him that. But it came to this
so
point
annoying, though,
it came to this point where we were like fighting this dragon and he fucking died. And Oliver, who was playing a paladin at the time, was like, oh, we have to save it. And I'm just like, dude, this is...
So we grabbed this dragon orb in this dragon's horde, like this ice dragon.
Yeah.
And I'd grabbed the dragon orb, and I'd managed to get it, and I was like, we've got to grab his body.
Yeah, so we had, like...
So that we can teleport, we get this teleport stuff, one-way teleport back, this other dragon.
And I was like, dude, dragon orb. There was like, us, a dragon, this guy. No, let's go. It's too late.
I could totally have reached his body in time, right? Because the dragon had been beaten up by this other character who was like a sorcerer of great power.
But I convinced him.
And he was like, no, you didn't convince me. I was like, we gotta go. And you're like, there's no time. And you broke the staff, right? And you grabbed me and smashed the staff over. And, and just like, oh, we tell him. I'm like, no, dude. And afterwards I was like, you know, I'm so glad you did that. I'm so glad. Character dead. It was a satisfying moment though, when the dragon finally got him.
Yep.
And just went, and he's like, oh!
His face was like,
and his face was like, oh! And the Wes said a good comment, and he was like, well man, you killed a lot of monsters. It was about time one of them killed you.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, what, like, really, like, checking his sheet for, like, anything he could do?
Yes.
There's a time
when... He's so sure that he'd be, like, saved, and he would be, like, fine, he would be, like, resurrect him or something. Something would save
and
him.
You know what, at that point, I was like, kudos, Wes. You do not let the guy live when he has pushed himself too far whilst fighting a very crafty white dragon. That dragon should get him eventually.
Fucking stupid about it the whole time.
He was, he just kept fucking pushing it too far. God. We were two jaded veterans who were just like, you know what, fuck this.
Oh, so that
was so good.
That moment was just years and years and years of like pent up angst about this dude's playstyle. And then I finally
sounds so mean, doesn't it?
I know, but
it's so true. I mean, look, you've all thought it. Let's be honest. You've thought it too. Okay, I'm just putting it out there.
Have you ever played in a group and like someone's gone like, I'm just gonna bring this friend along. I play with him in another group.
And then you don't like him at all.
And his playstyle is just so shit. You've done it.
You've done it or you've thought it.
Or you've been that guy. If you're that guy, you're that guy.
Don't be that guy.
Don't be that guy. No one likes that guy.
The other things I hate, right? is one of the things that will most drive me out of immersion in a game.
Yep.
Is when the DM clearly hasn't worked out a plot, has no idea what the fuck's going on, and you can see it.
Yeah.
And they're just now I talk a lot about improv, like you shouldn't like worry about it too much, but you should have an idea of the plot.
Yeah.
And work it out first and then be fluid with it, right? So have a familiarity with what's going on in the environment. And then have the characters worked out, their names worked out, for example, is a big one. That's a noob mistake that I still sometimes make, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I haven't worked out the character's name. You can see me thinking, what's the character's name? And I go, character's name is Fred. Even if I say it really fast, then you know I've made it up, right? That's shit. That takes you out of the game immediately, right? That's something I do that I hate, right? But I've seen other people do it too. And unfortunately, I'm a fairly critical player as well. Like, I'll enjoy the game for what it is, but if somebody's not good, I know.
Yeah.
And it's annoying. And so that will drive me out of the game and I hate it. Other things I hate, right? I haven't finished on my rant yet.
My God.
Still going, hating on things, right? Is when people don't, when they treat it like a computer game, basically.
Yeah, well.
They're sort of like, well, you're here and now there's a bad guy there and they come up to fight you. And now here's the hex grid. And I don't have nothing wrong with hex grids if you fucking like hex grids, but I just don't like them. You know how we are. And anti-hexes. Anyway, and then it's like, and then now they're attacking you, and now it's the round, and now, and it's so mechanical, and there's like, the description's all like, oh yeah, you kill him and he's dead, cool.
Yeah.
And then this guy attacks you, fighting, okay, that's like three damage.
X amount of actions this round.
Oh, for fuck's sake, how
I can move this far and attack, or I can attack, or I can.
Yeah.
Yeah,
or people focusing entirely on, you get this on virtual tabletop sometimes, you know, and there's nothing wrong with like setting up a good environment where you got like the map all worked out. That's cool. I mean, it takes prep work. I don't have the patience for that shit. So that's kudos to you. But if you're doing that at the sacrifice of the story, you're not describing it well enough, you're not really getting my mind working or helping me to do it together with you. Fuck, dude. I just can't wait for the game to end. Like, what am I doing here? I hate that with a passion. It's so boring. So there's like two ways you can do it, right? One way is you can just be like really like finicky on like, oh, well, you are walking here with some model and you now come into this house and you talk to this person whose name is, and I'm like, shit, could you make this adventure any more obvious? I mean, like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Or you can describe it and just talk. And you're like, well, you're in a town and, you know, the town looks like blah and recently it's been blah, and you're like, okay, well, it's pretty clear. But you start to have like a visual kind of idea of it. You start to talk to some people, have some chats, little chats, and they help out. You get to know people by how you're talking to them rather than just telling people. It's show don't tell, right?
Yeah.
You show people by the actions. You don't just say, you've been given a quest to go into the mountains and kill the kobold king, whose name is blah, and to get there you need to take this train with this guy who's a bit dodgy. Yeah. You're like, okay, cool, well now I know the adventure. Or you could say, you know, somebody comes up to you and they're covered in blood and they're shrieking and they're like, the kobold king took my daughter! Well, that's a little better at least. Now you know maybe why. You know?
Isn't that like the plot line of Labyrinth?
Pretty much, hey?
Yeah. Well, fuck Goblin King. A bunch of dancing. You know what I fucking hate?
David Bowie? Should love David Bowie.
Get the fuck out!
Do you love David Bowie? Because I do.
A, it's Bowie. B, no one can hate David Bowie.
Good. Those tights in Labyrinth were amazing. He could rock those tights!
Man, you see that bulge?
Oh man, it was real.
Getting all that bulge. Now, you know what I fucking hate?
What?
Groups that are too large.
Oh, fuck, I hate groups like, that are too large.
I know that everyone wants to join in and everything, but when you
but
got,
no.
like, over three players, and you enter a town and everyone wants to do, like, downtime
shit.
Stuff, fuck off! Look.
That's so shit.
Have you noticed how, like, this is the most animated we've been in the world? Yeah,
absolutely. Like, we're just getting warmed up here, people.
You've got, like, five people, and you're running a turn-based combat.
Ah, oh, fuck's sake.
In, like, D&D or Rifts.
Or even Immersion, man. Five people is pretty hard.
It's just, like, it's so boring as a player, and it must be, like, hard as a DM. And it's just shit. Especially if, like, one or two people are away in a different combat, and you're just like bouncing from group to group. You could have three different groups of people doing fucking different stuff.
Do you remember also, right, there was a game we were playing with White Wolf Rules, right? We were playing Star Wars. And Stuart's character was a pilot, and he was getting attacked by 14 enemy ships, right? Which does happen in real, like, aeronautical combats, right? And they were all doing something else, and he was in a combat. And it took, like, an hour or something for his combat, because apparently you got to roll for every one of the 14 ships, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, halfway through it, I was like, shh, this is taking forever, and it's boring.
Yeah.
I do not care. And so I ended up just picking up 14 dice and just rolling them. And that was the basis then of what became the Immersion system of just going, okay, how do we make multiple combats really fast? Let's make it one roll.
Yeah.
Let's make everything as few rolls as possible and make it really fast. And I found that really helped a lot.
Yeah. And like, I think we'd all just gone off for dinner at that point. Because we were just like, all right, this combat's going to take fucking 2 hours
at
least.
You know, who cares? You know, you could do that combat in one roll.
Yeah.
I just make it one roll these days almost, you know? It's like, okay, cool, we're gonna make combat. Okay, you have a big fight, you're fucking fighting 14 of them, okay, make one roll. If you fucking succeed, you win, otherwise you're dead.
Yeah, I mean, like,
it's pretty much it, you know? Like, or maybe they succeed by a lot, you get beaten up, okay, cool, you have a big fight, you get away. Whatever you wanna do, you could make it in 1, 2, 3 rolls. You can make it 5 minutes instead of an hour.
Really,
what's the importance of it?
Up to you and, like, your players, the narrator, the DM.
See, I like story more.
Yeah.
You like story more. We like to just like keep it flowing.
Yeah.
And I don't like to bore the shit out of my other players.
Yeah.
So like for me, I just don't care if it's that gritty. Like if we've got the time for it, for sure, let's get into the, like you poke him in the eye shit. You know, like you're on the ground. Or
we're almost 30 now. I mean, like we're
getting old.
Technically classified as responsible adults. Like I don't have the fucking time or the patience to sit around anymore and go through like 5 hour. Combats,
because
like, I just
what's the big deal?
I gotta be home and in bed by 11 because I want to get up and go to work. Yeah. It's like okay, like and like we only game like once every like few weeks now, so it's just like
so sad.
If you know, if I want to spend 5 hours doing combat, you know, like I'll go punch a brick wall. Like I prefer to just
faster
get through the game and like have the wins of completing the game.
Yeah.
And like combat is only like one very small aspect of the game for us.
Yeah.
It's like it's a means to an end because something, you know, you disagree with something.
Yeah.
So it's like, okay, get through that, finish the story, have the win, have the loss, whatever, finish the game, and like, fuck standing there and stabbing, you know, a troll for 3 hours.
And who gives a shit? Really?
Like, fuck that. Like, I mean, it was fun when we were kids, but like, it's just so detracting from the story in the end.
Yeah. Yeah. Long combats, I'm not a big fan, something I hate generally.
Yeah.
It's just kind of pointless. I mean, I played Palladium games, like Rift games, where they're like fighting for like 3 hours of game.
So it's like, it's like, you know, we played in the past when we were kids, like three games or something, two games, probably expanding way too much. It's like playing Dragon Ball Z. You know, he's just like, roll, scream, attack, roll! And it's just, it'll, like...
What the fuck is the point?
Yeah, like, that was the game back then for us. Now it's just like, okay, let's just get through that, have the story, be done with it.
Well, in a movie, right, for example, or in the reality of the game, right, it's like, you know, the old thing they say, you know, you can have a 3-day walk in D&D, it can take 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Or a 3-minute fight can take 3 days, right?
Yeah.
Or an hour, or whatever. It's a bit silly. I mean, like, in the reality of the story, it's supposed to be, like, 30 seconds to a minute of fighting, or, like, 10 minutes.
That's well, there a shouldn't really... long time of fighting. I mean...
Well, yeah, 10 minutes is a long time. I mean, like, a minute is a long time of actually trying to kill somebody.
Yeah.
When you're actually using real weapons, people are going to die, or it's going to end. So it should really only take about that long in the game.
Yeah.
I really think. And... You know, why should the other points of the game? I mean, like some people just play, they want to play fighting. Yeah. It's fine. You want to play fighting, just play fighting. But for a story-based game, well, if you're going to focus on the story, well, then the fighting is going to take about the same level of interest as the story.
Ooh, this is great. This segues into another thing that I fucking hate.
Fucking hate.
Fucking hate.
What do you hate, Jed?
Having a sniper rifle, shooting someone in the head,
and then
not dying.
Yeah. Too many hit points.
How the fuck does that make sense?
It's called rifts, man. But yeah, I mean, I love rifts, but...
When was it ever making, like, an assassin character in rifts
so
with a sniper
shit.
Rifle? When you'd never be able to pop someone off in the head.
And you get an MDC of 100 and your rifle does D6 times 10 and you shoot in the head. What the fuck? You gotta shoot him twice in the head. What?
It never, ever worked, and it was just so silly and like...
You gotta say it's satisfying though in Immersion, right, when you shoot someone in the head, right? Oh, the head absolutely. Explodes. Fairly satisfying.
So, a little while back, Oliver and I did this thing where we were coming up. I think we were doing the one roll combat thing. Mm. The one roll attack and damage. And we went through this like silly little like just test gaming. And we went for a couple of hours. Well, maybe not even a couple of hours, just an hour. Of just like having a character and just fighting each other.
Yeah.
Just to see how it was. It was fucking great because it was actually, so fast.
Surprisingly fast.
And like so realistic. It was like, we ended up just like grappling, beating each other with like chairs.
Do you remember that we did the mafia one?
Yeah.
And I was like, hey, Charlie! And he's like, I don't like you! And he's like, I don't like you! And like pull out, like, you get like a, what was it? You like beat the shit out of me. Yeah, with knuckle dusters, and I'm like bleeding, and I pick up a chair, try to hit you, and you just, you got a pool cue, and you stab me with it.
Yeah. And it was just like,
it was just like, so cool. I got fucked up.
But
man.
It was like, we went through a couple of games, and it was so great, because it was like watching like really gnarly movie or something, where people would beat each other with like random objects and would do damage. Mm-hmm. Like, if you have a gun and you shoot someone in the head, that person should not be fucking alive unless like supernatural.
At the very least, they should be in hospital for rather a long time.
A lot of fucking pain. Should not be happy after
this. The other thing as well is that in D&D, it's a bit like you're fully functional until you're dead.
Yeah.
Like, not to knock D&D, I actually like D&D, but I'm just saying. You're not fully functional. Okay, when you've been stabbed, you're fucking stabbed.
Yeah.
That's it, man. Game over. You're now out of that combat.
Yeah.
You aren't fighting anymore. You're too busy, like, holding your liver in.
Yeah, exactly. You may still be alive and, like, able to walk, maybe, but you're not fucking standing there fighting.
It takes an awful lot of exertion to actually fight.
Yeah, like, that's video game mentality. It's just fucking blah, 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 blah. Oh, my health's dropping. Oh, it's gone. Now I'm dead. Like, no, you're fucking, you're shot once, you're on the ground. You have a chance of, like, getting away and surviving, but you've been fucking shot, son.
Yeah. I don't know, I just find that loses a lot of the three-dimensional aspect of, you know, like,
I mean,
reality is kind of more interesting to me, to have it, like, brutal and more realistic, like, you've had your kneecap broken, now you're on the ground, it's not just like, oh, I've lost some health.
Yeah.
No, your kneecap's broken, bro.
Like, dude.
Like, bro, you're not gonna die from it, but it's gonna hurt. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, you're incapacitated at the very least.
Yeah.
I mean...
You hit your
funny bone and like that's it. That's 5 minutes of your life. You're fucking squealing.
Yeah, I got shot once in the neck, right, with a paintball gun, really close range. I wasn't expecting it, and this guy was—he was a dickhead. Let's put it that way. And I was already dead too. It was even worse. So he shot me close range with a high-powered paintball gun, and I just dropped. There was no like, ow, shoot back. No, it hurt. I'm dropping to the ground, shrieking like, holy shit, I just got shot in the neck.
I mean,
like, look, right there.
The argument of adrenaline.
Yeah, which is why we have resolve.
Yep, which is fair enough.
But it's momentarily.
Yeah.
It isn't like you're gonna keep mishing through the dungeon.
You're gonna bleed to death.
Like, let's go.
Yeah.
You know, something that AJ was talking about, right, is love about immersion rules, actually, was like, you get smashed up, you're gonna get smashed up. If you avoid it, you avoid it.
Yeah.
But, you know, you can't, like... Like, you could describe hit points as, oh, I just managed to avoid. Well, that's fine.
Yep.
And that's fine. Up until you get down to a certain point, then you'd start getting really chopped. You know, maybe like down your base hit points. Like
radiant.
Yeah. And that's fine. You could be avoiding it for a while. But I find it fairly unrealistic.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's my rant on that.
I kind of view that, like, Palladium's STC system was supposed to be like that.
Yeah.
But it was never, like...
Portrayed that way.
And, like,
and also, once you had MDC, SDC, and hit points to me, no difference.
Yeah, exactly. So it was just like, you got through that, and then HP was kind of just like this, oh, okay, I'm actually getting trouble.
That's the problem with armor. I mean, like,
in
Rifts. Again, not to knock Rifts, I really like it, but I'm just saying that armor made no sense.
Yeah.
It was like either all good or just destroyed.
Yeah.
You know, oh, I've got 10 points of MDC left, so therefore it's totally fine. That's not how armor works. Really not.
No.
You know, like, no. No, it's not like that at all. Ugh. Anyway.
Man, that was a big ramble.
We've been ranting.
This video is going to be at least half an hour.
Of all the things we hate.
Yeah.
We're not even being constructive at all.
No.
We're just being like... we're just being hateful.
We'll put a disclaimer right at the very start.
We'll get some comments though at the bottom. Oh, I mean, there'll be a lot of people.
There'll be a lot of people being like, oh yeah, but. Oh yeah, but stroking their neckbeards.
Or also just being, why are you so negative? I just totally disagree with you.
I mean,
it's fine.
That's fine.
I totally don't care. It's okay.
We welcome opinions, different opinions, because obviously
we've got our own opinions.
We've got our own opinions, and like the different opinions that we will then get is something that we may add to our own opinions. We may assimilate them.
We synthesize them.
So I mean, if you've got an opinion on anything we've said, go ahead. You know, we'll read and fucking.
And you can rant as well.
Yeah, go.
We will accept your rants.
Like,
just be aware that we may not agree with you. We may, but we may not.
And that's fine.
That's fine. Totally fine.
So
we have strong opinions.
Yeah,
that makes it fun.
We're very opinionated, and that's like how the whole system came about, really.
Yep, being opinionated. Like, well,
this is shit. Let's do something that we enjoy.
Yeah.
So
it's fun. You know what's cool though? I do like is meeting people like Keith Capel, who's just like so cool.
Yeah, dude, Keith was a badass.
anyway, well, we've kind of exhausted ourselves on all the things we hate.
One day we'll do a...
Why don't you give us a list? Instead of just ragging on us and telling us how much you hate us, which is fine, why don't you give us a list of all the things you hate as well? We'll just make this one big hate-filled thing. Just ranting about the things you hate. Just let it off your chest.
Yeah.
We're just airing.
Tell us something that you've experienced in your games that you don't like. Because then, you know...
This is somewhere that people can vent those things without judgment.
The only way you can fix things in games that you don't like is by letting people know.
That's right. Or just not playing anymore. Jet's done those ones. It was funny sometimes.
Yeah.
We play with somebody. And Jet'd be like, yeah, it's cool. Yeah, it's cool. Yeah, it's cool. And then he'd just be like, no, actually, I can't play with this person anymore.
Yeah. There's been a few times where I'll be like, oh, I'm going to bring this guy. And be like... Nah, I don't know about this. And they'd be like, yeah, cool. And I'd play like a couple of games and be like, text Oliver a couple of weeks later and be like, yeah, I just can't.
He just doesn't like the game style.
Well, I mean, like I used to do when I was a kid and we go through all these games and I get super pissed off and now I'm just like, I just really, really, if I'm going to dedicate, you know, 5-6 hours to gaming, I just want to fucking enjoy it.
You got to have fun. That's the thing. You can't go if you're fucking hating it.
Yeah.
You know, it's that simple.
So, tell your DM what you don't like so you can fix it up in the game.
That's right.
And then tell us, because we want to know and chuckle.
Nah.
And it's just something we can address as well, you know, like...
I must chuckle.
So, from Oliver and myself, this has been a good ramble. Ramble over.
Ramble on.
We're doing that in reverse now. We're doing that again. I want to do that again.
From me and Jedi. Ramble over.
Ramble on. And it's just something we can address as well, you know, like...
I must chuckle.